Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is the first video of my channel, and in this video I will be discussing on how to increase flowering in bougainvillea. So let's start. I would like you all to have a look at the 8 bougainvilleas I am having on my rooftop and how they are flowering or not flowering, we will see. The first one, this is a white bougainvillea. This has been flowering a lot, and it is almost time for the flowers to fall off. So slowly the flowers have started falling off, and this is the time to prune it again to get a fresh lot of flower once again. So this is a Mahara variety. I have planted two such plants in this pot. One is of this pinkish orange color, as you can see. Another one is purple, which has not bloomed right now, but there are actually two plants in this pot. Come to this yellow variety of bougainvillea. This plant is almost 2 years old, and interestingly I water it every day. Although it is not recommended to overwater bougainvillea, but if you may have a look, the pot of this bougainvillea is broken, so whenever I water it, most of the water drains out. And interestingly, out of all the bougainvilleas, this one gives me the most flowers throughout the year. Last year it grew to a great height as compared to the other plants. So now we are seeing three other varieties of bougainvillea. This one I have grown in a very small pot, so it has not increased in size. Quite similar to the one on the left, while this one on the right I am planning to make it even larger than this. So I have been watering this very much, so as you can see the flowering on this one is very less, and most of the plant is covered by green foliage. So I am planning to increase the height of that one. So this one has been also flowering, and just a day before I have pruned it. So most of the flowers are now gone. We come to this plant. This is a much younger plant, most probably 2 months old. As you can see, this one is not flowering. So to induce flowering, I have pinched off the tips of this plant. As you can see, the tips have been pinched off, so as to promote new growth from the tips, from where the flower buds will emerge. Similarly, we will see another plant. This is even younger than the previous one. This one is at the most 1 month old. So this is growing profusely, as I have been watering it regularly. I want to make it taller, so I have not pinched it off till now. So I will wait and see how it goes. We'll discuss some of the methods I use to increase the flowering of my bougainvilleas. So let's see what are those techniques. Factors responsible for increasing the flowering in bougainvillea: sunlight, watering, pruning and fertilizing. So let us discuss them in details. Bougainvillea cannot tolerate gloomy, shady area. It needs sunlight, the more the better. At least 6 hours is a must. The bougainvillea is place it in a shed in indirect sunlight, because in indirect sunlight it will only give foliage and no flowers. The lesser you water your bougainvillea, the better, but personally I have got better result by watering my bougainvilleas regularly and ensuring good drainage. Flowering, I water it every 2 to 3 days, only when the leaf starts to wilt, otherwise I don't water it. And when flowers are there in the plant, you need to water it regularly, otherwise the flowers and the buds will drop off. The most important step to make your bougainvillea flower more and more: bougainvillea flowers on new shoots, new branches. This new branching, you need to prune your bougainvillea regularly. Whenever the flowering is over and the flowers start to fall off, you need to prune all those flowers. You need to pinch off the tips of the branches to stop the growth of the foliage and promote new branches, so from where buds can emerge. You need to hard prune your bougainvillea to keep it in good shape maybe say after monsoon or just after the winter is over. Now pruning is done. As you can see in this bougainvillea, the flowers are almost spent off and they are starting to fall off. So you need to pluck off all those flowers along with the nodes from where they are emerging. But you need to be careful and see whether new buds are also emerging or not, so that you don't pluck off the new buds. Only the flowers which are spent off and will be falling off shortly needs to be pruned, so that new branches emerge from those pruned off areas and another lot of flowers can grow on your plant. This is very important to encourage new branching and new flower to come to your plant. As you can see here, the flowers are starting to fall off and they collect on the ground on a regular basis. So this is an indication for you to start your pruning. Whenever you see the flowers, the color is changing, becoming discolored, or they are starting to fall off, you need to prune them to encourage further flowers to come up. So let us have a look at this bougainvillea. As you can see, some of these flowers have started discoloring and becoming whitish in color, whitish yellow. So it is time to prune off these flowers. The more you prune off these flowers, it will encourage further new flowers to come up in this plant. Although you may not feel like plucking off the flowers because your plant is looking so full with flowers, but believe me, this will encourage further new flowers to come off. These are the flowers. See, the yellowish tinge of the flowers have decreased, so it is time to pluck them off. Fertilizing. So bougainvilleas are heavy feeders and you need to fertilize them regularly to get the most out of them and make them flower profusely. In a month, give them a fertilizer comprising of bone meal, superphosphate and potash in the ratio 4:3:1 to increase the flowering. Potassium. So along with other fertilizers, you can also feed them with banana peels, which can increase the potassium content of the soil and give better result with flowers. These are some of the leftover banana peels. Let us see how we can apply them to our bougainvilleas. So I have shredded off these banana peels into smaller pieces and I will directly place them in the pots of the bougainvilleas. You can also soak them overnight in water and make a solution out of them and apply that also. But I find it much more easier to directly apply them on the bougainvilleas and it gives me the same result. So I am just applying here, just placing them in the pot. And after that, I will be watering it. With banana peels, you can also apply bone pieces after washing them properly. That can increase the phosphorus content of the soil and increase the flowering. Potassium. Bougainvilleas also need small amounts of magnesium for healthy growth. And for that, Epsom salt or magnesium sulfate can be quite useful. If you want to increase the height of your plant, you need to water it heavily and apply NPK and DAP in alternate doses every 15 days. These simple tips, you will be able to increase the flowering in your bougainvilleas. So happy gardening to all of you. Thank you for listening.